nation has been so designed that it can produce enough food for itself. And with modern logistics, we can handle it. So that's my first response to your question, sir.
Sir, my name is Sakshi Dwivedi, PGDM first year from Jaipuria School of Business. And I would like to ask how the youth of the country will survive in this complex scenario.
You will survive very well. You know, complexity is meant for
no,
you.
No, sir, according to you.
My feeling is that we will find it difficult to survive, you know, because we will not be able to deal. No. Look, the fact is that while the world is becoming complex, your abilities to handle the complex world are also increasing. You know, both things happen simultaneously. Whatever field you are in, so whether you are into, you know, because look at the opportunities that are available to your generation. I mean, in our generation, as Arun and all my friends would tell you, there was only the government or the private sector or the public sector or the media. You know, I mean, you could join the Times of India or the Government of India or one of the PSUs. I mean, today the whole world is open for you. You could be an art illustrator, you could do anything. So I think in this complex world, there is the possibility of niche specializations. There's the possibility to follow your interests. You know, do whatever you feel like doing. You could be a great teacher. I mean, so I think opportunities today are far more abundant than they were in our times. And of course, it's a very general question, so I'll only be able to give a general answer. You can talk to me on the email, and then perhaps we can have a more forthright discussion on what specifically you would like to do. Right?
Thank you.
Good morning, sir. Sir, my name is Mona Lisa, and I am a student of PGDM first year, Jaipuria School of Business. My question to you is, probably there are two methods, traditional and the new methods of following any scenario, the current scenario that we are talking about. What, according to you, is better usage, I mean, the traditional method or the new methods?
No, you see, let's put it like this, that as far as the Indian tradition goes, you have to follow whatever method doesn't make it. Basically, there are two ways of learning. There is the Socratic way of learning, which is that we keep asking questions, right? We keep asking questions. So it's a dialogue. It's a dialogue mode of doing things. And then there's the Platonic method, you know, which says that this is the truth and thou shalt follow the truth. Now, these are two ways of learning. I think both are required. You know, you need, for example, you need the case study method. You need the case study method to be able to build scenarios. But you also need your quantitative methods in management. You know, you need that because unless your base is strong, you can't do other things. So you require a bit of both. I think that if we go overboard with the case study method, then also it will not solve the problem because you need to get your concepts cleared. The concepts have to be clarified. I mean, the concepts have to be strengthened. And then the concepts need to be discussed in a free classroom atmosphere and also in the field. So you know, I'm sure under Mr. Mahapatra's leadership, he'll also be giving you assignments. So you learn and so both are required. I mean, and that's why there's a wonderful word in English. It's called praxis. That is, you know, the unity of thought and practice. So what you think, if you're able to do what you're also thinking, then that is an excellence model by itself.